Hello and welcome back to Rollercoaster Tycoon, where we are in a lovely garden, apparently owned by someone called Geoffrey, though I know better. It is definitely owned by Damage Incorporated. Awesome tycoons for rollercoaster businesses. Yeah, that's us. And well, so far the park is doing quite alright. It has a bit of an odd color scheme to it, but it does have my favor and fancy. I quite like it. We're also developing it in rapid pace. This is just 1 year's work, and it is good for luring in a good 700 guests into the park. That is quite a feat in and of itself. But that's only, well, we will still need 1,300 more. And we only got, well, wow, we actually got exactly 3 more years to gather up 1,300 guests in the park. And good thing is there, it is quite a profitable park. Now, seeing how we're a year in, let's start out with our traditions of pricing check and vandalism check. And we're gonna use the new method that I quite like. So we'll sort it by profit and then sort. I guess it's actually quite odd that it only sorts upside, you know, it only sorts it descending, but hey, what can we do, right? Now, the controller red. Yep, there it is. Oh man, this is quite a solid method, actually. The wood steel, though, yeah, that's kind of new. Oh my good lord. We have created a freaking awesome super ultra coaster over here. Wow. I mean, that's all I gotta say about it. Wow. It is good. It is amazing. Very unconventional track design, but for this type of coaster, if you get a 5.5, you haven't done bad. If you get a 6, you've done well. If you get an almost a 7, you've done exceptionally well. Of course, we're gonna open that up. Pricing is good. It's even a little bit on the low side, but hey, I don't mind. Anyway, we need to adjust the pricing of the controller red. So, we'll lower it to, I don't know, 30 cents. That probably still means that it won't make a profit, but I don't really mind that much. It's not there to make a profit. I mean, the rest of the park, everything is making a profit, even the toilets. Oh, that's quite good. Anyway, we also need to do a vandalism check, which we'll quickly do. But, as far as I can tell, everything looks rather nice. Now, I don't know, we have quite a few of these jumping fountains in there, alright? They also can get destroyed, but that's quite difficult to see, because, I mean, they're just these green, well, knobs, really. And, yeah, I always have difficulty spotting whether or not they're destroyed. But so far, it seems that the guests are behaving very nicely. So, everything is in mint condition. Good stuff, then. Well, as you can see, currently the park is pretty filled up. And if we disable the supports, you can see that pretty much all the path that is readily available has stuff in it. So, we need to expand our area. And I have this area that we're looking at right now in mind, which basically means that we need, like, I want this area, right? So we need to cut it off over there. We then need to cut it off over here as well. And then, well, look at this, man. This is all kind of rubbish, really. I mean, I know it looks nice, supposedly, but look at these flowers. I mean, oh, this is unbearable, you know. I can't stand this, really. So, also, this is a square, and squares are bad, you know. The guests get lost easily, so I guess what we should do, really, is just replace this thing over here with the information kiosk. Anyway, what we'll do is we'll first get the path hooked up there. So, let's see here. We go with these, and with these. And you know what, we'll first actually remove the paths that we don't want, and then we will continue building the paths that we do want, which is right over there. That's one, and another one, come on, right over there. Look at that. Alrighty, so that is another very big section added, but of course this section needs to be taken care of, so we'll get a handy dude, and well, I was about to say, like, you're gonna do this whole new section, but I think that that might be a tad bit too extreme, just a hunch. So, you know what, we'll give him this area, which is still pretty big, but we'll also hire another one just to ease the workload a little bit. Oh, handy dude number 11. The fact that we're only on 12 handy dudes right now is actually quite good, you know? So, right, well, there we are then. Do we need one of those and one of those? I guess we do. So, you know what? We'll hire these as a precautionary measure, really. Now, we'll have an elephant, you know, for some good mixtures. And, of course, the next thing that we need is interior. So, yeah, wow, look at this. The first guests are already walking over here to find out that there's absolutely nothing to see over here. Well, benches right now, soon trash cans too, but I don't think that's what they're coming for. Now, I am gonna leave those jumping fountains over here. So, I mean, they're quite expensive to place. Look, 25. There's a lot of them, and the guests like them, so I don't see why we shouldn't keep them. However, this new section, huh? We need to get some facilities over here, because the closest ones are over here. So I'm guessing that we should place another batch of these facilities, like, right over here. This seems like the proper place for them. So that's also where we will place them, though actually, I mean, ideally, we'd have them over here on this stretch, but seeing how this is not part of our area of operation right now, we won't build them there. So, let's see, huh? We need the info kiosk. Now, I do wonder, before we build this, what is the color scheme of this one? No, of the info kiosk. The gatehouse map supplier is white, so the one that we are going to place over here is going to be grey. There. Now, let's see, and we will call this the Rose Garden Umbrellas. Yeah. Alright. You know, no. We're gonna call this Rosie's Umbrellas. Yes, yes. On there. We're not gonna make them pink, though I guess that would actually be quite cool, you know? Because they're roses, you know what? We'll have bright pink umbrellas. Why not? Alright, cool stuff. So we'll open that up, and we then need to place a batch of facilities. So we'll start out with the toilet, which we will place right over here. There, and we'll call this, yeah, we'll call this Pond View Crap House. Yeah. Totally. Oh, actually, it doesn't have pond view because the door is facing the other way. Small details. And I guess that having windows in the bathroom also isn't the most great idea I've come up with. So, never mind. It's named like that. We'll keep it. Now, we also need drinks over here. So, we'll get those two. And we'll call this we'll go with the vendor of bubbles. Right there. And then, you know what, we'll also get a frying thingy there. So I'll remove the tree and we'll put it right next to it. So we really have this shopping lane, so to say there. Frying thingy. Oh man. Oh well. Well, that'll do, I guess. So, well, Now that we got this area more or less set up in a rapid pace, we have more room for our guests to wander around it, and we also have more room to put in rides. So let's take a look at what we're gonna put over here. Now, we have built a slide there, we have a ship, and I guess the real thing that we would need here is either a gentle ride or a thrill ride, or maybe even both. Yeah, I guess we could get away with both, really, though. See, we need to build compact, but I don't want to stack all the thrill and gentle slam down rides right on top of each other. And look at the space that we have. So even though we're going to build compact, that mainly applies to tracked rides. So what we're going to build over there, I'm thinking of doing one gentle and one thrill ride and get some coaster tracks in the rest of the areas. Which shouldn't be that difficult, really. So we'll build a gentle ride first. Oh, miniature golf, huh? Yeah, miniature golf it is, alright. So, we'll build this. Also, I don't need that open. we don't need the park thingy. We have that all covered. Now, we'll remove a few trees here because this is where the miniature golf course is going to be. And I'm actually curious whether or not we would be able to build a queue and exit in different places. I don't know, I don't really need to find out though. This is a bit of an issue though, although I guess we could get away with placing it over here. I guess, over there, yeah, this will do. Right, so, loads and loads of options for the miniature golf are becoming apparent once again with just four holes that we could, design here, really, that we can place. I wonder, though, whether or not we could now... I don't think we can go underground with the miniature golf. Would be quite cool. You know what, I've never tried that. Wow, underground... Oh. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, we just got ourselves something that is going to happen. I'm telling you, we're gonna have underground miniature golf right here. It's a first for, you know, me, but hey, there's gonna be first time for everything, right? Look at this. Underground miniature golf. How freaking cool is that? I think that this is something that has never been seen before. Granted, it's not really that expensive in the underground, you know? Like, in the sense that there's a lot, but hey, you know, this is the first. This is the final park in the first expansion, and we still have something for the very first time here. How cool is that? Wow. Underground tracks here. I think that's just freaking amazing. Now, we'll also add in hole B, and there we are. I think that this is quite the cool miniature goal. We won't really have it set up for our ultimate, repeat guest because the exit's gonna lead over here and the entrance over there. But that's not really, you know, an issue, I think. Just underground miniature golf. I mean, wow. I think that's just freaking amazing. I've never even heard of that existing in real life, really. So, can you imagine that we have things here that doesn't even exist. Oh, well, it probably exists, you know, some underground miniature golf. I just never heard or seen it, you know. Maybe that says more about me, though. Then again, I mean, miniature golf isn't really, you know, one of my hobbies, so to say. Yeah. Anyway, we'll have this hookup over here. There. Perfect. Now we will work with a no entry sign there because the exit path isn't really that great, but never. Now, let's get some quick benches out there, like so. It's not really needed, it's a miniature golf after all, but now, let's give this a quick name, and of course we're gonna open this up. It's freaking underground! Wow, it's just awesome, man. I really thought it wasn't possible, but then I looked at the menu and I saw, like, hey, this It just looks like we're building a track only with fixed, track layout pieces. It's just so cool. Wow. Anyway, yes, we need to give this a color scheme. We could go with black and then, I don't know, I go with white or perhaps dark red. No, I don't like that. I don't like that much, really. Yeah, if this is concrete and this is yellow. Yellow looks kind of okay. If it just looks green and this looks more like a white. That looks okay. This looks less okay. That looks not okay. This? Nah. No. No. I guess it's the white that looks good. What if we just dark blue? That does look really good, I must admit. Now these fences, huh? Are they? I don't think we can even see these fences. They're just for the supports, really. But well, we don't have any supports. Yeah. However, this is cool, man. You know what? We're gonna call this Cave Golf. Oh yeah. Oh man, that's amazing. Wow, underground. I still can't believe that this is actually possible, you know. It's quite cool. Now, we need a thrill ride, I feel. So, the question is, of course, where? Because it's not gonna be over here. That much is pretty much for certain. So, I'm guessing it should be over here somewhere. I mean, this area would fit the bill for it, though it's a little bit cramped when it comes to entrance and exit constructing. Though I guess we could work our way around it if we, well, if we build it over here and then have the exit or the entrance, I could just go around a little bit, I guess. Yeah, a bit over here and then maybe up, down. I don't know. It's not really, I don't know, it doesn't really appeal to me, that spot. The other alternative is over here in this corner, which appeals to me a lot more, really. We could also go over here, but there's already a lot of things there, so you know, we could always leave this out for something else, really. So yeah, I think over here would be the best place. So what are we gonna put there? Ah, this would also be very. Oh no, I think. No, we wanted the slide. This would also be very nice there, but it's gonna have to be a. Oh, well, the next best thing then. The other. Oh, wow, look at the rides. Eggheads, what can you still receive? Oh, there's even more stuff to come. It's probably the water rides, actually, I'm guessing. I can't imagine. Oh yeah, we need a roto drop as well on this one, but. This! Yes! Nice! So, we'll build you. It's gonna be over here, this one, so. No, come on, build it. There. Oh man, this is so good! This ride will make us a lot of money, and yeah, the guests just love it, man. And I love it too, so. Yeah, it starts at height 15, so we need to go up to. No, height 47. This isn't really that high, so we'll go there, and that should do it, really. Then, we will have this go all the way over here, and you over there. We'll need to start with the entrance, otherwise it's gonna hook up to the exit, which, of course, is a thing we do not want, so I guess we could go with that, though. Yeah. You know what? Fine. We'll go with that, and then we'll have just a simple exit path like that. Have a no entry sign there like that, and two very needed benches. I'm not going to remove these fountains, so we will need an extra handy dude for this one. Most definitely. Now, another thing that I feel is missing is music over here. I know this music over here, but still, you know, it's way too quiet in this area. So, we're gonna add music, and we are going to add a rock style too, because I freaking love that music from the previous park. I really discovered it. You know, it's like, wow, I didn't know that was in the game. So, and now I'm gonna enjoy the my discovery of it some more. Now, I know that this will be good, so, oh, you know what? Let's actually test it so we know that it won't fly off. No, it won't fly off, so we can open it up. Yeah, and you could hear those early rock vibes already kicking in. You know what? Why we will call this the yeah we oh I mean this is a real cheap one, but we'll call this rock shocks. No, actually we'll call this ground shock there because I mean that's a brand and I feel I shouldn't use, you know, front suspension brands as naming. I think that's too cheap, though. Anyway, this is set up. I believe we got everything right, all except a handy dude who is going to be assigned over here, and I feel that's direly needed. That's good music, man. I really love it. Now then, wow, I'm actually quite curious. Look at all of these guests golfing over here. What are the ratings? Oh, we don't have test. Oh, yeah. How about we actually adjust the pricing to what it's supposed to be? We don't have ratings though, but the guests, they're digging this. I mean, look at this, man. They really love underground golf. Cool, cool. Now, the next thing. Well, in my eyes, should be a coaster. I know we don't really have the money for it, but a tracked ride right next to this one, I feel is a no. So I want a coaster, and ideally, this is, I don't know if I can pull this off, but if possible, I would like a duo coaster. So what I'm thinking of is having a station that kind of pops out from the underground over here, goes right next to this exit, and then has two coasters paired up with each other leading to this area. We could have one covering this area and especially this side of the mountain a little bit before returning, and then the other one could just be above this very square. Question is though, which coasters are we going to use for that? Not you, because of lack of money. Not you either. You are a very good candidate, and we could also build you. Now, if I were to choose, this one is, I mean, I'm just inexperienced with it, which isn't really a good excuse, I must admit. You know, having played the whole expansion, still haven't used it much. So you know what? We're gonna give this a try, and or we're gonna give this a try, really. To be honest, we are not that, well, good when it comes to cash. So it's gonna be you, because I know that this one can be had cheaply. And if we wanna build across, above this section, we really need one coaster that's flexible. He comes in to play the wooden crazy rodent roller coaster. So we're gonna build you. Now, in terms of planning, let me quickly see over here. I guess best spot for this would be, yeah, we would need it, this one to be bordering the entrance, and then the other one right next to it. And well, I guess we would have the entrance over here and have the paths cross over, which isn't really ideal, but I guess that's what we'll go with. So, yeah, all right, fine. It's all planned out right now. So, let's build this. And let's see. I believe that this would be the right height already. Yeah, it is. Nice. Very nice. Right, so we would need to raise or lower the land, which I guess is a good indication of the fact that we would need to go underground right here. So we'll do that. Look at this. Alright, we'll just raise this one square up a little bit. Right, station platform too long. That's actually good. Now, just to gather up some cash, we're gonna hook this coaster up first. Let's see. Ooh, we are actually three below as well. So we could even build the exit underground question is, should we want that, or is that smart, really? I don't know. I mean, if we build it there, where are we gonna hook it up to? That's the other question that I have. I guess we'll have to figure that one out right now. So, well, actually, it's not that difficult, really. We could just hook that one up, like, right over here, really. You know, it would just have to, like, See, for that to happen, we would need to go below this coaster track, because we can't go above it. Can we now? Yeah, no, that's not gonna happen, really. Well, unless we, of course, lift this one up with a lift, so it has to come from below, and then we could go above it and make a zigzag, and then... Yeah, I guess it could work, actually. So, alright, it's decided. We are gonna have this be done, just as I mentioned. There. Right, that's how we're gonna have it set up. So let's actually get the paths out first, yeah?
Also, to get a little bit cash as well, we're gonna need that.
The park is profitable, you know, and a good, well, big amount of profit is coming into our pockets, but yeah, we're gonna need more than almost 3 grand for this coaster. I know that already. So... this is also to kind of like have this be less ugly to look at, you know, so we just cover it up with path, really. Let's see, I could do this, really, but then again, I don't really think there's much... Yeah, right, we'll do it. Fine, we'll do it. We'll actually go down there. And that's not where I wanted to hook up. So, we'll go like this, and then there. And then we would need to do some terraforming. Right, that's much more suitable. Now, we need holes, and this is gonna be tricky as crazy. What? Yeah, we got it. Right, nice. Yeah, we would need to go up by one, and right now we can't really go up much further, so... But we don't really need to go up that much. I mean, we're already around this station, so if we go up right now... Look, there we are, very nice. Very clean looking as well, you know, it's not really, well, uglifying the park all that much. Right then, well, let's close all these. We don't need them anymore because we are going to be coaster designing. So, now, we'll start over here with a lift up after some terraforming. That's also needed. So, let's see. Well, of course, the good thing is as well, we're quite high up here in this park. So, we can use the height to our advantage, and I'm inclined to do so. So, let's see here, huh? First of all, we'll have a big drop. Oh, the river rapids! Nice! I knew we would get that, but it's always nice to see that confirmed. Well, I wasn't really, like, certain of it, you know, with a 100%, but... I just had a feeling that we would get it because this is the last park and all that. I also think we should perhaps lift the coaster here because of speed issues. Now we can have a tight curve there. And then another tight curve. And I know, we're not really going that fast, but... Fear not, my friends, we are gonna have this coaster and be absolutely freaking awesome. So, you know what, we'll have a little twirl around the sides over here, and then, like a shoe, and then down into the depths, and then, I guess like this, and then, but we hit the lock view. Alright, so... I guess we'll go down like this. It's a lot less spectacular when it's done like this. Right, so we are at height 13 right now. Which, no, we're actually at height 16, so I can't go that way because the coaster will be in the way. That's pretty much a given. So, let's see here. Now, we could go up, I guess. So why don't we? All to have a big drop in there once again. Just like this. Yes! Oh, I don't think that this is gonna happen, but hey. No. That ain't gonna happen. I got that right, pretty much right from the start. So, instead though, what we'll do... Yeah, alright. So, we will have a drop, but then it will have to go like this. Just above the river rapids, really. I don't really like that, but fine, this is how it's gonna be. Now, currently, we still have a ways to go when it comes to track designing. And, well, you know what we could do, I guess? We could go over here. Question is, though, you know, I just fear that the speed on it will be way too extreme when we do that. So, there, we'll have some track length added. So, this is purely, you know, to act as a natural brake, really, for this coaster. So, and then, oh, how cool would it be if we could go below those tracks? Oh, yeah, and I think we just pulled that off. Like, spot on, look at that. Ooh, this coaster, man, it's starting to look like a proper thing right now, you know, it's becoming a piece of its own. We come from height 18, and... Well, I don't really want to fill up too much over here, so I guess we will go right over here. Now, speed will probably be quite high on this one. And there is a small chance that we've already extremified this coaster quite a ways. And if that is the case, I guess it would be over here. But we'll have to see there how the ratings turn out. The ever so important ratings. Now this is also quite cool because there's all these trees over here which we can just go in between with this coaster. And that's really good actually to boost up the ratings. So. Right, we'll also do that. Go all the way over here and then just like this. And we'll actually dig it in and go one further straight and then up and I don't know, can I do that? No, trees. Right, one further straight, and we are in the underground. Now, the station is already at height 12, so, you know, we can forget arriving right at station height with the track at its current Z level. So, we won't even attempt that. We'll just go for, well... I guess it wouldn't be such a bad idea, and I'm looking, you know, with one eye at the cash meter in the bottom left. I guess it wouldn't be such a bad idea to go back to where this coaster belongs, which is, like, the station. Let's see, if I do this, how would that line up? I think I would be one off, wouldn't I? Might have... Good feeling tells me I wouldn't be one off, I would be spot on there actually. Right, so I guess we would actually need to go up steep even. There's a footpath in the way. Right. And then there's a coaster in the way. Great, so we need a proper approach angle too. We can get that. This is where we would need to be. Let's see, huh? Alright, now we're at height 8. And now we're at height 12. And... Oh, we're one off. Fine, that's not a biggie. There. Derp. Oh well. Right. Retry. Now. Let's see. If I just go up here. The footpath is in the way. So that means that I just need to extend the straight section a bit. Footpath still in the way. Fine, we'll extend the straight section even further. And then the roller coaster is in the way. I wonder, now if I were to just do it like this. Footpath in the way. Maybe one later? Yeah. I'm having a feeling that this whole footpath issue is making it impossible to hook this one up here. Which, in which case, we would kind of need to remove it. And then, you know what? Maybe, that's not gonna work. But I do believe that right now, yeah, it's hooked up. We just need to pretty much raise this one square up, build the exit right there. And we'll just have to fix that real quick. I mean, that's not the main issue. Right, so we got ourselves this coaster right over here. And I am dying to have a test ride on this. Took quite a while to get it sorted, but it's there now. Hopefully it isn't too extreme. I think the track, though, is astounding. It looks rather well, and it really goes around, leaving open a lot of space for future track designs, you know, future coasters and all that. Hopefully it's not too extreme, that would be quite unfortunate. Well, aim at $6 for now, and yeah, let's have a test ride whilst we go about and set up benches, handy dudes, and you know, all that jazz. Come on, I need this view. And the benches are one thing that we are sorely going to need. And I believe that I don't have them right over there now. I also don't have them... Man, this is actually rather tricky to get on the right spot, because the path is pretty much below another set of paths. See? Yeah. It's not really allowing for anything. But not that fine. And I'll put some trash cans right over there. Come on, there we go. And ooh, it's even lifting right now, so I guess it's Ooh, it's arriving at the station though. Alright, well, how did we do in terms of G's, huh? Not too bad, I guess. Nothing major. Vertical G's? Nothing above 4 G's. 3.5 is quite extreme though. I don't know, we'll have to see, I guess. Ooh, look at that, ladies and gentlemen. It is spot on. I know it's not grand, but we can make it grand by adding more stuff to this. Now, because there's quite a good section underground, I hope... Nah, it's probably not rainproof, which is a shame, but hey, you can't always have everything. So, we'll open this one up, and why don't we call this... we will call this the, yeah, we'll call this swine rats. I don't know, it's a rare breed of swines and rats together. But I can't even imagine how that would look, but anyway, we could also have mine trucks. I'm not going to though, all it would do is add intensity to the ride. Now, if we zoom out a little bit, what's my microphone doing here? I don't know, really. So, if we take a look at the ride and the coloring, I must admit that this white doesn't really look so bad, but we're not going with it. No, and we're also not going with that, because reasons. I also don't like that one. That's a no-no. So I guess the white actually doesn't look so bad. So you know what, we'll go with that. And we'll then have, you know, these be black. Yeah, alright. I guess, well, you know, the default colors it came with are actually pretty good. So, well, there we are then. We got ourselves another coaster that is just waiting to be... Oh, balls. You know what I just derped up here? Big time. Very big time. I derped up in the exit there. I just now realized this. Though, then again, what we could... No, no. I was just thinking what we could do is build the station the other way. But no, that ain't gonna happen. So, we'll have to devise a solution for that. Probably a much shorter station for the next coaster. But how exactly we're gonna fix that is something that we'll leave for next time when we play more Rollercoaster Tycoon.